The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "Happy are your eyes because they see, your ears because they hear. I tell you solemnly, many prophets and holy men longed to see what you see and never saw it, to hear what you hear and never heard it." The Gospel of the Lord. Dear brothers and sisters, thank you very much for coming to this day of Mary to celebrate the feast day of Saint Joachim and untraditionally known as the feast day of grandparents and parents. In ancient tradition, the Church honors Mary's parents as Joachim and Anne. Nothing truly trustworthy is known about these two people, since the information about them is based on the apocryphal writings known as the Proto-Evangelium of James and the Book of the Nativity of Mary, as it is sometimes called. These works, written to make up for the lack of detail about Mary in the New Testament, were composed in the second century. There is no doubt that the authors included much that was pure speculation. Joachim and Anne celebrated as saints, which they surely must have been in order to have reared a child of such a great sanctity. Mary was a descendant of the line of King David through her father Joachim, and perhaps to her mother Anne as well. Her birth from David's seed had been predicted by prophet Isaiah, Jeremiah, and Zechariah. Saint Paul declared to the Romans that Jesus was of the seed of David according to the flesh. He told his listeners in Antioch that Jesus the Savior was brought to Israel from the seed of David. Paul also urged Timothy to remember that Jesus Christ, raised from the dead, a descendant of David, that is my gospel. Today I would like to say something about Mary's life of faith. And she must have been sanctified and nourished by the sanctity and faith of her parents. Mary is the woman of faith because of faith of Joachim and Anne. Her cousin Elizabeth says of her, "Blessed is she who believed," that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord. Mary responded at the Annunciation with an entrustment of her whole being to God. This action represents a perfect definition of faith. Saint Pope John Paul II, in his encyclical letter Redemptoris Mater, compares Mary's faith today to that of Abraham, whom Saint Paul calls our father in faith. The Pope goes on to point out, "Abraham's faith continues the beginning of the Old Covenant. Mary's faith at the Annunciation inaugurates the New Covenant. Just as Abraham in hope believed against hope that he should become the father of many nations, so Mary at the Annunciation, having professed her virginity believed that through the power of Most High, by the power of the Holy Spirit, she would become the mother of God's Son in accordance with the angel's revelation. Mary's answer of yes was filled with great faith and was the starting point of her whole journey, her own pilgrimage of faith. Her faith continued to grow throughout her life until it reached its supreme test when Mary witnessed the death of her son on the cross. Mary's faith never diminished, and through this faith she accepted the word that will pierce your soul too, and with this final agreement she became perfectly united with Jesus in his suffering. What does this mean to us? Mary was the first pilgrim of faith in the ways of life which Jesus taught in his public ministry. Her faith was instrumental in first miraculous sign given at the wedding in Cana. Disciples, after seeing that first sign of Jesus' glory, learned to believe him. But Mary had faith ever before the sign. She had the seeds of faith from Joachim and Anne. There must have been many events in the life of her parents which she remembered, which were nourished by the faith of her parents. That is why she is emerging at Cana as the mother of all believers. In dark and lonely times, when you're filled with fear and anxiety, when you're weighed down by troubles, remember that you have Heavenly Mother. Make a place for her in the home of your heart. Even if your faith is little, small, and shaky, if you want to know what perfect discipleship means, meditate on Mary's life. She is the headline to copy. A disciple, me and you, are to be open to receive the divine word and heavenly grace. See how Mary was totally open to letting it be done to her according to the heavenly word. A disciple is the one who cooperates with the graces received, and we receive them in such a immense measures. Blessed is Mary who believed and who put the word of God into practice. This is our task. A disciple will carefully observe all commandments. Meditate on Mary, the family woman, diligently observing all that was laid down in the laws of religion. She is the selfless woman who let me go out from home on my mission to other people. She is the woman of strong faith, who stood beside the cross to accompany Jesus into the dark valley of suffering. She is the woman of the new age of resurrection who prayed with the disciples in the upper room. She is taken up in glory of heaven, a sure sign of hope to all Christian pilgrims, to me and to you, and in heaven, her mother breasts feels for all the suffering children on earth. So we have every title to pray to her intercession, invoking her help and the help of her beautiful parents, Joachim and Anne. May this day strengthen us on our pilgrimage of faith. May it give us the grace, and the Lord knows, and Mother Mary knows, and Joachim and Anne knows what graces, in particular, each one of us needs for today and the days to come. Amen. Amen.